Oh, I get it. Best practices, best practices, best practices. Best practices in nutrition supports an omnivoric diet. What does that mean? That means I can eat blueberries, carnivores. I can eat wild-caught salmon, vegans. I can and should be doing this because that is what the healthiest, highest performing humans of all time have eaten. They've proven it. I don't care what niche random study you can find from 1927 that has one line in it that might make us think, huh, that's interesting, to conflating that as if every single human on the planet should be following these restrictive, exclusionary, fad dietary programs. It's not like we didn't think about only eating plants or only eating meats eons ago. We have and they've tried it, and guess what? It doesn't work. For best overall outcomes, an omnivoric diet is by far, like it doesn't even like compare by far. So what's the debate? The debate is sales. The debate is marketing. The debate is a measuring contest. That's the debate, but it's flawed. And this is my plea to all educators, all fitness-minded individuals, everyone who has a platform, start telling the truth. Start telling the truth, right? What's the truth? The truth is a diet that comprises of a wide variety of healthful, wholesome, earth-grown nutrients, fresh, local, in season, minimally processed, minimally prepared, minimally tainted with by man's greedy little hands. If I'm eating that in abundance, regularly, that will by far allow you to live the longest, healthiest, most enjoyable life you can imagine. I get paid to produce results. Remember, a 100% success ratio for over 20 years. If this wasn't what I did to do that, I wouldn't be sharing it with you and everybody would know. You know, I've been saying the same thing for almost that time, almost those two decades. The first 5 years, I was a little more sports performance oriented, a little more pills, powders, potions, going trips to the GNC and BCAAs and all. I went through that and I learned immediately the exclusionary, restrictive, fad dieting, pill, powder, potion mentality does not work. That was my learning curve the first few years of my career. The last 15 years, we have been crushing it with a 100% success ratio. No other team, no other coach can make that claim. We've done that for over 20 years. So at least listen to me when I tell you that the exclusionary, restrictive, plant-based, exclusionary, restrictive, animal-based, and I should not say based, I should say only. Because if you're mostly plant-based, and you have maybe a little bit of a cross-flow microfiltered whey protein isolate, do intra-workout, because the plant-based proteins, they simply take too long to digest. A whey protein isolate is the fastest digesting, most efficiently accessible protein on the planet. It just happens to come from dairy. So plant-based community or plant-only community says you can't have that either. That doesn't make sense from a health and a fitness perspective. Not when best outcomes and best practices are looked at. And the same thing with the animal-only community. The animal-only community will go and suggest eating four patties from a Wendy's with American cheese on it and bacon. But you have to pull off the lettuce and you have to pull off the tomato, and God forbid, you better pull off that bun. That's what the animal-only community says. I can eat this nasty neon processed cheese and these four crappy patties at some local fast food joint. What is that even? That's what you're suggesting, animal-only community? This is why I get so mad and speak as passionately as I do. It's all crap. They make it too hard to try and trick you, to fool you. They try and make it hard and confusing, and then they stand on authority because they have one stat from someone else's work that was completely conflated to suit their current narrative. That's what happens. Sorry, guys. Sorry, my friends out there. I love you guys, fitness friends, but why can't you just tell the truth? Some of you do. So it's, of course, not all, and it's a few of you. Whether I know you or don't know you, I'm sure we know of each other, right? Why not just stand there and tell the truth? I understand your SEO. I understand your Google keywords. I understand your Facebook pixels. I understand your retargeting audiences. I understand your warm traffic, right? I understand it all. But you don't have to do it that way. You can just tell the truth and still do all that stuff and now really over-deliver on value to the end user so they stay with you forever.